Well, our next guest has had a huge career. First came the starring role on Neighbours, and then came the powerhouse pop career. There she is. And look, one of her biggest roles to date is mum of two gorgeous kids. Please welcome the gorgeous Natalie Bassingthwaite to studio. Yes.
Hi. Look at you.
Ooh, I want to start
double leather.
I know.
She's rocking double leather.
Rock leather at 9 o'clock in the morning. I love it.
I was going to say, it's double leather. It's good.
Now, when you became a mum, you know, what was it like sort of juggling career and your kids? Was that tough?
Yeah. I mean, I think any mum I know knows that it's one of the hardest things you ever have to do. I think, you know, especially with Hendrix, like it was a few months after and I was back on air, which didn't feel that great at the time. But I was breastfeeding and I would, like, have, you know, rehearsals and I'd be like, gotta go, and they were so great letting me kind of come in and out, apart from the live element, which would have been a bit disturbing for people if I breast.
You look very calm, though. You look very calm,
Oh, it's so funny when you see these pictures of pat pictures. I love it. I just have the best kids. They're just... You know, they blow my mind. They're just so inspiring. They're completely crazy at times. Tantrums, which is funny. Yeah, you know, like it's fun.
It's interesting too, though, that when your life changes and the kids come into it, if you're a creative person, it kind of pushes another part of your personality to the fore. So the clothing label, in a way, is an expression of love for your kids and being able to be creative in a different way.
It definitely invigorated me in another way.
I'm slightly concerned that your son models the girl's clothing.
My daughter didn't want to have a bar of it the first season. She's like, I'm not trying anything on. I'm like, right, Hendrix, you're here to try these dresses. And he was so young, he'd just kind of wander around and none the wiser.
Perfect.
So tell us about the label then, the clothing label that you've got.
Look, I started, it's a unisex label, monochromatic, low crotch pants, very urban and edgy, primarily made from bamboo. So it's really beautiful for sensitive skin. It's so beautiful.
It's like MC Hammer pants for kids.
Totally. I want them myself.
And when you say monochromatic, non-gender specific, that means basically that before they get to puberty, you just treat them all the same, which is absolutely perfect for having a child. So you just don't...
Pass them on.
I do find there's so much pink and blue and... You know, there's nothing really cool and rock star, but...
There is now.
I know, it's amazing. It's brilliant, your label.
Yeah, I wasn't that into the kind of baby blue, baby pink thing, and I couldn't really find that anywhere, so I kind of went on this mission and and now it's, I've given birth to my third child.
I'm a communist. If I had my way, everyone would just be wearing grey overalls. in fact, you probably don't remember this, but we actually have a mutual friend and we met at a barbecue for a birthday party, and a big shout out to Timmy G. No, it's true.
And
we were just about to...
Tara
and I were just about to have our first baby and this lovely couple came along and we were just chatting, saying, oh, so what have you got? You've got the baby boomer Q X pram or whatever it was and blah, blah. And then off they went and I said to my friend Timmy, I said, gee, that couple's really got it together, don't they? You know, they seem fine, you know, they're good looking, they're perfect, they're all cool. That was Natalie Bassingthwaite.
Oh, I sound great.
Right. I just thought, what hope for the rest of us?
Oh, no, we're not all together all the time.
you seem to be coping very well.
Oh, you know.
And your pram was very impressive.
You've got to have a good pram.
You had a lot of pram memory. It was like one of those... Was it the Skoda?
Now, you're the ambassador for the One Fine Baby Family and Lifestyle Fair. It's happening in Melbourne next week. Tell us a little bit about that.
Yeah, I know, I know. It is the most... It's like nothing out there. It's the most beautiful fair. You can shop to your heart's content. But are there some of the best vendors in the country? Cheeky's going to be there. I'm going to be there. Ply Room, Kip & Co. Peppa Pig, Jumping Castle.
Oh, yay.
Sam Moran.
This is exciting.
You want the Jumping Castle?
I love Peppa Pig.
Oh, you like Peppa? Yeah. Sam Moran, petting zoo. So
oh,
it's
George.
A great day for anyone.
In our household, when Peppa Pig comes on, everybody competes to be George. For some reason, we all just want to say dinosaur.
Dinosaur. So it is really one of the most beautiful. It's the first time in Melbourne. You can get tickets online at onefinebaby.com.au. But yeah, I'm just excited because it is like none of the other kind of ones that are out there. It's really beautiful and really curated spaces and. You can shop.
You've certainly got a lot. There are lots and lots of first-time mums that watch the show. I'm about to be a first-time mum. Yeah. What advice would you give to us?
Oh, look, I think
everything what was the that name happened. Of the pram? I just want to know. The name.
Everything that happens goes so fast. And even though at the time you think, oh my gosh, and you're pulling your hair out and you're so sleep deprived and, you know, it's hard. It'll go, you know, it's like a 24-hour thing or it might be a, you know, a week thing, but then the next week there's something different. So sometimes it's hard to think, oh, this is never going to end, this hard moment. It's like so difficult, but then it's fine. And so it's, you know, swings and roundabouts.
Enjoy the ride.
Enjoy the ride. It's crazy and it goes so fast.
All right. Well, you can meet Nat for yourself and check out her kids' range at the One Fine Baby Lifestyle Fair. It all takes place in Melbourne this weekend, October 17 and 18, and in Sydney next month on November 14 and 15. We'll put those dates on our Facebook page. Nat, thanks for coming in.
Thank you.